I'd like to welcome everybody here today. My name is Glenda Strauss. I'm the brand manager for the Institute for Open Learning, and I will be your master of ceremonies this morning. I would like to welcome everyone this morning, and first of all, I'd just like to introduce everyone on stage, our registrar, Mr. Pieter van Vieren. He is the IOL registrar. Then I'd like to welcome Francis Simata from the International University of Management. Also, I'd like to welcome Ms. Ilana Karlitz, the head of IOL. Hipa Murangi, he is our COO, ICT Learning. Then I'd also like to welcome the Honorable Governor Kashipulwa. I'd also like to welcome Reverend Martin Ukule, who will do our scripture and prayer this morning. All right, what's going to happen this morning is we're going to open with scripture and prayer first. And I would like to welcome Reverend Martin Ukule to the stage, please.
Good morning, everybody. As introduced, my name is Pastor Martin Ukule, and I'm also one of the staff members of the Institute for Open Learning, IOL. So it is an honor to me this morning to be standing in front of you, to share the word of God with you, and to open our ceremony and dedicate it in the hands of God. Without wasting time, I would like to read our scripture for this morning, which is taken from the book of Psalms. We are going to read Psalm number 1. It reads as follows, in Jesus' name. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or stand in the way of sinners, or sit in the seat of mockers. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. He is like a tree planted by the streams of waters, which yields its fruits in the season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever he does prospers. Not so with the wicked. They are like chaff that the wind blows away. Therefore, the wicked will not stand in the judgment, nor the sinner in the assembly of the righteous. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked will perish. Amen. The word of encouragement this morning starts with the word blessed. It starts with a blessing which every living creature desires to have in their life. But here the Bible tells us that the blessings are for those that fear God, for those that delight in the law of God, for those that let me put it this way, for those that meditate on the word of God. Today, when I entered this place, the Lord put something into my heart that I need to tell you. That for you to graduate today, especially for our graduates, you might not get it easy. Some obstacles, some difficulties when you went through, but today you are here to receive your award. In the history of the Bible, God delivered the children of Israel from Egypt to the promised land, or to their destiny. But on the way, they faced a Red Sea. But today I see here a red carpet, meaning that whatever obstacles, whatever Red Sea that you went through your studies, today have turned into a red carpet that you are going to walk on. A red carpet of honor, a red carpet of discipline, a red carpet of respect. So I just want to encourage, especially those that only graduate in the first year of their academic careers, that whatever you are going to face now, be sure that whatever obstacles, whatever Red Sea you are going to face, that determines your red carpet on the day of graduation. Let us bow our heads as we are going to pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning that you have made it possible for us. Thank you for this day. It's only you, Lord, who could give us this morning, the day of our graduates, the day of celebration. Father, I pray that you take over all our programs, that your Spirit shall lead us and guide us. Father, be with us, protect each and everyone, bless our graduates, bless their visitors, bless our parents. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you very much. I'd also like to acknowledge our invited guests that are here today, the Education Director for the Ohankwena region, as well as the VVTC Liaison Officer, and also Mr. Thomas Nyoma, the Development Bank of, from Development Bank of Namibia. We'd like to welcome you all here and thank you for taking the time to share this day with us. All right, we're moving on with the program. Our next address on the program is done by Mrs. Ilana Carlitz. She is the head of education or head education at the Institute for Open Learning, and she'll be doing the welcoming address on behalf of the Institute for Open Learning. Ilana.
Honorable Governor Kashim Mpulwa, IUM representatives Francis Imata and Charles Nyambi. Pastor Martin, who is actually also a staff member of IIL. All invited guests, all IIL staff, all tutors present, family, friends, and most important, our IIL graduates. Thank you very much. And good morning and welcome to each and every one of you here. It is really terrific to stand here today where IOL's students are graduating. This is actually IOL's second graduation where students from our own developed courses are graduating, and IOL is so proud of that fact. So, IIL had another graduation ceremony in Windhoek a week ago, last Friday, and in total about 200 students, or just over the 200 students, is graduating from IIL this year. And for the first time, there's actually students from our pre-primary diploma who is also graduating. Now, Master of Ceremonies, invited guests, tutors, family, friends, and graduates, it's a tremendous privilege to stand before you today. There is nothing that IOL enjoys more than celebrating great achievement. We hereby congratulate the IOL graduates for 2015 on graduating from the largest distance education institution in Namibia. Let's give our graduates a tremendous round of applause. What a special day and what a great achievement. IOL makes it possible for all students, including those with poor financial means, to achieve any of the educational dreams. The financial assistance and the course offerings allow students to change to succeed. And I just want to give you a little bit of a background about our IOL. Now, when IOL took over from the Open Learning Group in 2005, IOL, they had around about 2,500 students. IOL grew the enrollment to more than 50,000 students. Now, the Institute commits itself to excellent recognized educational programs, involvement with public and community educational activities, and becoming one of the foremost distance education institutions in Namibia. We take great pride in announcing that more than 9,500 students have graduated from IOL. Now, this is an equally special day, of course, for our parents, the grandparents, the siblings, and other family members whose support made all of this today possible. And let's not forget, of course, the tutors and the IOL support staff, those dedicated individuals who taught you and who often came up with interesting ways to share their knowledge and experience with you. Now, IOL is tremendously proud of all its graduating students, but today we want to especially salute the graduates who have persevered, often under tremendous difficult circumstances. Now, many students face difficult challenges such as financial difficulties, family problems, and even health problems, which makes it extremely difficult for them to succeed at their studies. However, passion for education and perseverance in the face of such challenges makes them ideal candidates for learning success. It takes a lot of perseverance and dedication to complete one's tertiary education, especially through distance mode, where utmost discipline and sacrifice is required. You have achieved a remarkable milestone in your lives. Education is the key in achieving our personal life goals, but also the goals of the Namibian government. And you are directly contributing to the attainment of Vision 2030. Students' success is realized when a positive spirit and determination to reach out and accomplish their fullest potential, thus doing well with their lives. Great responsibility comes with receiving an academic qualification. You carry the responsibility of educating and inspiring our future leaders. I urge you to nurture this responsibility with as much discipline and perseverance as you have shown in your attainment of your qualification. You can do it. Whatever you want out of life can be yours. Just hang in there and don't let anything stand in your way. Don't let the ways of the world cause you to strain from whatever goals you have for your life, even if those goals seem impossible for you to reach. Now, on behalf of IOL, I wish to once more congratulate each and every one of our graduates. Thank you.
Just before we continue, I would like to welcome once again Mr. Charles Moyame. He is an IOM representative. And then again, Mr. Francis Simata Moya. He will be doing the address on behalf of IOM. So I hope that I've acknowledged everybody on stage now. Thank you very much. I'd like to welcome Mrs. Francis Simata Moya to the stage now to do the welcoming address on behalf of IOM.
Thank you very much, Madam Director of Ceremony. Maybe a question will come today, why is IOM here? We are also involved in the same business with IOL, and we are offering also some of our programs by using IOL on a distance mode. It's for that reason that Simata Francis Muya and Charles Momani are here today to witness this great occasion. Thank you very much, IOL, for this special invitation that you have brought to IOM family to witness this great accomplishment of your own students and our IUM students who are studying with you through open mode of study or distance route of studying. Allow me to express our thanks to your committed team of administrators, lecturing staffs, tutors, mentors, and all involved for your vibrant academic cooperation and institutional friendship between IOL and IUM. Director of Ceremonies, Madam, allow me to recognize the protocol that has been already been established, but let me single out that I would like to acknowledge the presence of our regional governor of Oshana region, Honorable Clement Kashupula. I therefore would like to welcome all graduates at this year IOL 2015 graduation ceremony in Ongwendiva. At the same vein, I would like to welcome the parents, sponsors, family members present at this historical achievement of Namibian Human Assets Accomplishment. Dear graduates, as you graduate today, allow me to welcome you to another university. Maybe a question will be, what type of university is this man talking about? The University of Applied Knowledge. You are to become human assets, not liabilities. By being human assets, you'll be able to contribute positively to your own beautiful land or to our motherland, Namibia, through the skill that you've acquired through your learning, that you can be able to become somebody who can contribute positively to this country. As a member of IUM family, allow me also to welcome our own graduates who are also going to graduate this morning, that we are much proud of you, dear graduates. Graduates, you are to become innovative in this 21st century. You need to explore new ways, new ideas. Try to add value to yourself. Try to add value to the organization which you are going to serve. And try to add value to the organization that you are serving currently. Dear graduates, there is a difference between the two, to be certified and to be educated. To be certified, yes, you get a certificate, but to be educated, you can be able to use the skill that you acquired today to bring a positive change in human life. So I would like to advise dear graduates that we must take the second one, to be educated, that you can be able to acquire the skills, and we can use the skills to improve the livelihood of many. Indeed, there are so many challenges that you are going to experience in the labor market. However, there's an African saying that goes, tough time that never lasts, but tough people, they last. So we are tough people, so we must be able to succumb to challenges. Therefore, you are among the tough people. Fight the battle, become victorious in your new assignment, that you will be able to apply your new acquired skills to bring a greater change to our motherland. Finally, I would like to welcome you to this Harvard School of Applied Knowledge and wish you a great and enjoyable memorial graduation. I thank you.
I think Mr. Moya is a gentleman that moves fast and acts fast and speaks fast, because this was quite an inspiring welcoming. Thank you very much, sir. All right, then up next, I'd like to call forward on the Honorable Governor Kashupulwa. He will be doing our keynote address for this morning.
Yeah, thank you very much for the opportunity that is accorded to me by the Director of Ceremony to make a statement. Mr. Ilana Galitz, Head of Education of Institute for Open Learning, Mr. Petrus van Vieren, Registrar of the Institute for Open Learning. I also recognize Mr. Simata Mwia, the coordinator from International University of Management on Ongwendiva campus, Mr. Charles Nomanyi, Head of Academics from International University of Management on Ongwendiva campus also, our spiritual leader of the day, Martin Ukule, distinguished staff of
the Institute of Open Learning, their graduates, their parents, family members, their friends, the invited guests, comrade and friends, good morning. Oh, ngoro ina andisi. Yeah, wrong. Yeah, first and foremost, on behalf of the entire leadership of Oshana region, and indeed on behalf of the government, I'm here to congratulate and commend the Institute for Open Learning and its entire staff for having created a conducive environment for learning for our people in the Republic of Namibia and also in our region. The Institute for Open Learning is really doing quite a good job in supplementing government efforts to address skill deficit in the Republic of Namibia that we have experienced for many years now. And that also led to poverty challenges. So really, we support this institute for its commitment and also investment in education. Then it gives me a singular honor to thank the leadership of the Institute of Open Learning for the cordial invitation extended to me to make a brief statement on the occasion that marks the second graduation ceremony of the students of the Institute of Open Learning here at Venice Entertainment Park in Ongwediva town. I'm therefore delighted and I feel honored to share views with the graduates on your future role in the development process of our country after your successful studies in various academic fields at the Institute of Open Learning. May I therefore, on behalf of the entire leadership of the region and the government, congratulate you all for the new career you have so far chosen in your social and economic endeavor. Dear graduates, today marks an important day in your future lives. This is an important achievement in itself, to which I commend you. The personal competencies that got you here, that is the passion, the commitment, tenacity, and open minds to learn will be important throughout your lives. You need only to nurture them. They will be even more important than what you have learned. This is a major step in the journey of your lives, one that should be recognized for its immense significance. It is an act not only of personal commitment, but also one of pride. You all work very much hard to get to this day And your work did not go to waste. So that you must be very much proud about that. An academic qualification is a wonderful tool nowadays in this world. One that open many doors or for opportunity for anyone who has sacrificed enough to have one. It involves sacrifices. It was not a joke, it was not easy. But here you manage it. And we are really very much proud of you. So then bear in mind, graduation is not an end goal in itself. It is instead a part of the larger journey of life. Whatever your future takes you, let it take you somewhere. Because life is a journey. And all accomplishment we achieve during its course should be taken as a starting point for further achievements. Meaning that you shouldn't end up there. You need still to continue to study in order for you to have a decent life. This graduation should serve you as a such as a launching point, projecting you to whatever your future are meant to take you. Whether you land yourself in a career, take a business risk, or continue your education for higher gratification. So really, don't end up here. You need still to proceed. This graduation proves how capable you all are, for accomplishing your goal when you commit yourselves to them. And I hope all of you, the graduates here today, can take this personal accomplishment as an example of how anything is truly possible when we put our minds to it. As you continue on your lives, take each new problem on with confidence, knowing that you have achieved great heights and are equipped with the necessary tools to build up a decent future. The road that lies ahead won't be easy after this graduation. You still need to work very much hard, because there will be obstacles, there will be potholes, and sometimes also roadblocks. There will be times when each of you will feel like you cannot possibly go on. And there will be time when each of you will think you are isolated in a community and society at large and beg against the wall. See, this is the situation in which you might find yourself still. But you need still to work very much hard to overcome that, just the way you did when you studied so very much hard, and today so proud to have achieved your goal. Yeah, but you will never be alone in this kind of challenges. We are a family, all in this journey together. And you made it thus far. And nothing worthwhile is easy. And that includes making the most out of your future. But that does not mean we give up ourselves. Never give up in terms of study. Please proceed. Now you get the way how you always to succeed. So you will keep pushing because you know you can achieve your dreams and because you are worth for it. So this is just encouragement I'm trying to give you at this time in point in order for you again to proceed with your study. After all, we believe in Namibia that learning is a lifelong issue. Hence, really, the opportunity is still yours, and make use of that opportunity. Now, dear parents, as you reflect today at your sons' and daughters' successes, you may be thinking back through the years of great challenges and obviously success, sacrifices of both material in cash and in kind. You have given your children, your son and daughters, your relative, the support they needed. Now they have achieved their goal. And you have also worked extremely hard to help your young adults into the future perspectives in many career development. So please keep up with that good work. It's going to reward you in the near future as a family, as it's also going to reward your son, your daughter, who has now succeeded to achieve his or her goal in education that we are all today celebrating in this beautiful hall. So for that, you really deserve a round of applause. Yeah, that's why you are here. So really, you must be proud, because whatever you have given to your son, your daughter, to help her, you know, to study, today, it's now not a wasting of support, but a successful support that you have, you know, lent that to your sons and daughters. All of these years later, you are here because your children have mastered the academic skills required to graduate and head out in the world to make a decent life on their own. I know there are some of the parents who could not be here today just because their sons and daughters and relatives perhaps did not do well. But as for you, you must really be very much proud as a parent. And that is what we all are doing to support our children in order for them to be able to earn a decent life and also subsequently support us. Distinguished graduates, you may be thinking back to the days when you forced yourself to get out of bed to study, or when you felt too tired to finish your assignment. But you did. I'm sure you realized that you must work again to succeed and felt a sense of pride when you got that good symbol. And now you have the chance to make a difference in your community and also in our society. I'm sure that you have all had the African proverb, and I quote, "It takes a village to raise a child," end of quote, quotation. And in this region, we are all part of the education family. As a graduate of 2015, you are heading into the real world during the time filled with financial challenges. But yet, the opportunity have perhaps never been greater. You have been educated in a technological world, and you are the generation that will take technology to new and possible incredible heights. I'm optimistic that your generation will also bring solutions to environmental concerns, domestic violence, drug and alcohol abuse. Yes, now that at least you are on your own, please ignore this kind of drug abuse, alcohol abuse. It won't help you anything, but you should now concentrate on all this, to think back, not even to waste your money, but rather just to support the parents that have supported you in achieving that goal you, you have achieved now, either financially or morally. And try also now to contribute to our society towards the development of our country, Oceania region included. So this morning, as you vacate this venue, visualize yourselves opening a new door leading to new adventurers. With the skill you have attained, you should absolutely be eager and ready to challenge the next phase in your life endeavor. Whatever it might take you, wherever it is, just stay focused. Our world will only change as a result of your efforts. Efforts that will be determined by how you choose to realize your dream. And I therefore challenge you to take risks. Set good goals and continue your quest for knowledge. I also urge you, therefore, to find ways to give back to the society, the community, and the family that have given so much to you to be at what you are today. Also, don't forget the friends you have acquired who challenge you along the way. They remember that true friends is a blessing, and they too are part of your success. It means that during the course of your study, you had good friends that encouraged you to study very much hard and now to achieve your goals. These are the really friends you need to be together with them. I know many of the people, they tend up to have bad friends and join cooker shops just to abuse alcohol and so on. But when it comes to you, did not have many follow that, those are bad friends. So please stick now to the best friend that will always help you to take a lead when it comes to whatever you are going to do in a society. Yes, people are saying that if you happen to give a politician a platform to talk, politician never finish. They continue just having to talk and talk and talk and so on. And even now, you see that we are now campaigning. You say, yeah, Ashpola will again add their campaigning, campaigning, campaigning. No, I'm not going to do that. I have really meant to stick to this occasion. Just I meant to encourage you. What you supposed now to do with the knowledge and the goals you have achieved in our society, how to proceed, and also to be advised also by the rest of the people. Finally, from this day forward, let us be focused and make each decision with our best interest in mind. Let us believe in ourselves so that we may reach our goal and fulfill our dreams. You must believe in yourself, not to be told that you cannot achieve this, not to be told that you cannot do this and so on. You must believe in yourself that I can achieve this. And through that challenge, for sure, you will succeed. Let us be the best that we can be, so that we may fill our lives and the lives of those next to us with happiness and pride. You have already taken the first step by making it to this ceremony today. And now it's time to take the next step in the journey that is your lives, and begin to build your future, and begin to build your prosperous future. I admit we have worked hard for this moment, and if you hold fast to that faith in yourself, in your country, then the greatest moment of your journey are the ones that still lie ahead, with the blessing of our Almighty God. Congratulations, my dear graduates, in this noble achievement in your educational career. And God bless you. With this remark, thank you very much. The parents, the staff, the graduates, for your kind attention. And I thank you very much for the opportunity, Director of our proceeding. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Honorable Governor. All right, we get to the proceedings where everybody's been waiting for, the highlight of today, where you actually receive your qualifications. So the ICDL graduates, please come forward. Could the First Lady please proceed? Thank you very much. This is Lahia M. Shiponeni. This is Miss Anna Itula. Hilda M. Petrus. I almost had a B in my face now. Hilda M. Petrus. This is Francina Joseph. Francina Joseph. Okay, ik laat dit wel terug hier om keer te gee. Thank you. This is Justina Ngolo. Albertina Shitunyenga. Yes. Advent Ngelenge Mbanga. Hendrina Kulermo. Lachia Shikongo. Elizabeth Avula. Tufelis Angunku. Lydia Herculano. Julius Limey. Limey Shivolo. Ioana Nekwaya. Foibe Datilela Watlenga Watlenga. Ndevama Mbinge. All right, so that would conclude us for our ICDL graduates. They have all received their international computer driving license. Let's give them a big hand. Up next, we have our Microsoft Electronic Training graduates. Can you please come forward? Microsoft Electronic Training graduates, please come forward. Thank you very much. This is Abel Kasale. Naluliwa T. Kamati. And then Jose Andoshike Serverin. That concludes it for our MET graduates. They have received their Microsoft Electronic Training qualification. Let's give them a big hand. Now, the Institute for Open Learning has opted to start developing its own programs and courses, and the Diploma in Pre-Primary Education was one of, or is one of these courses that is own to IOL, and we have one graduate here today. I'd like to ask her to come forward, please. Her name is Martha Beacus. She's completed her diploma in pre-primary education. Congratulations, Martha Beacus. Let's give her a big hand. This is a 3-year qualification and it's registered on NQF level 7. Well done, Martha. I'd like to call for the Advanced Certificate in Secondary Education graduates to come forward. The ACSE graduates, please come forward. The Advanced Certificate in Secondary Education is also developed, or it's also owned to IOL. It was developed by IOL for IOL graduates. And of course, it's also on NQF level 7. We are very proud of this qualification. Can you come forward, please? Simata Cynthia, she did ACSE with English and Geography. It's an advanced certificate, which means these are already existing teachers. They're just upgrading their qualifications. Kamui Florence, ACSE, English and History. Give that one to her. Yeah. All right, then we have Ipinge Maria, advanced certificate in secondary education. This is a smart lady. She did English and mathematics. The following teacher is Beatrice Simasiku. She also did the advanced certificate in secondary education in English and history. Just a second. Albinus Veronica, she did ACSE, English and Mathematics. Mwanga Prisco, and Prisco also did ACSE, English and Biology. Simasiku Eunice M, she did ACSE, English and History. This lady is Hilma Amukugo, and she did ACSE, Geography and History. And our last, very last ACSE graduate for 2015 is Albertina Haushona, ACSE, Geography and Mathematics. Our following qualification, ACPE, I'd like for them to come forward, please. Advanced Certificate in Senior Primary Education. Let's give a big hand to the ACSE graduates. The following qualification, Advanced Certificate in Senior Primary Education. Thank you, Ms. Johanna Shanigwa. She did ACPE, English and Social Science. Congratulations to you, Salma Shikongo, ACPE, English and Social Science. Thank you very much. Feska Matengu, ACPE, English and Natural Science. And our final ACPE student, Tusnelda Haulu, and she did ACPE, English and Natural Science. I'd like for the International University of Management graduates to come forward, please. It's not just one, Katrina, there's two. All right, can you please come forward? Thank you very much. This is Paulus Cyprians Shipiki. He did HIV/AIDS management. He has completed his certificate. You have a big smile on your face. Are you happy? Very happy. Well, congratulations to you. This is Eilish Shanika. She also completed her certificate in HIV/AIDS management. That would be it for the IUM students. And then finally, I'd like to ask the IOL policing students to please come forward. Certificate in policing students, please come forward. All right, up next we have the IOL registrar once again. He will then award the qualifications to the policing students. The policing certificate is also accredited by the NQA and it's also developed by IOL. So we're very proud of you students graduating here today. Can you come forward, please? Thank you very much. This is Luoke Mazizi Martin, and he did his certificate in policing. Congratulations. This is Mumangeni Twitileni, and she did her certificate in policing. A lot of police officers here. Gabriel Antonius, certificate in policing. Thank you. Mumbala Madusalem, certificate in policing. And our very last lady police officer. Her name is Victoria Shimbome, and she did her certificate in policing. Can we give our graduates a big hand, please? All right, then we get to the next step in our program, or the next part of our program. It's the announcement of the top five achievers. Now, these students, we all know that distance education is not easy. It's quite a difficult task. And our top five achievers, we took from all our courses overall. They were Alma Mbonge, MET, Jacqueline Kurtz, she did DPPE, Jürgen Milano Okhuizen, he did ICDL, then Eustace Limbo Lesulo, is he here today? Eustace, are you here? He is from IUM, he's also the top achiever, and then for the IOL Business School. And then Lennox Shakanda Musialike, policing. Is Lennox here today? Well, we still congratulate them in their absenteeism, and we are very, very proud of our students. All right, that would then conclude most of our formalities for today, and I thank each and everyone for being here today. I would like to call on Hipa Murangi. He's our COO for ICT Learning. He will do our vote of thanks for this morning.
A man fainted in front of KFC. And so a lady that saw him went ahead and said, "Let us get him some water." They came with a jar of water to give him. He opened one eye and said, "Hey man, if I wanted water, I would faint in front of NAM water." So on that note, I want to say that we have now witnessed some interesting accomplishments. ICT professionals, teachers in pre-primary, teachers in senior primary, teachers in secondary primary, officials in HIV and AIDS certification, and also possible police officers. So that is quite an accomplishment. I would like us quickly to just give everyone a round of applause on that. So it is my pleasure to stand before you to give thanks to the talents on display. We believe that graduation is not the end, but the beginning, a new beginning. So I am wishing you luck. Your goals and aspiration, we have no boundaries as you move on onwards to higher grounds. Our head of education, Lana Kalitz, who spoke with such aspiration. Honorable Governor Kajipulwa, we only have aspiration for you. Your address to the graduates of Never Give Up. Giving up was really touchy. And your words of wisdom will forever fill their cup. I also have to thank our colleagues from IUM, Mr. Francis Simata Muya and Mr. Charles Muyame. Thank you to all the IUL staff for taking time to be here and your dedication to our students. Our students are our main stakeholder. I'm certain that they will really relate to all that was said from the head of IUL, from our Honorable Governor, and also from Mr. Muya. Let us not forget to thank the family and friends for your support, both in the academic world and also in our community, your dedication you have surely displayed. Our esteemed Mrs. of Ceremonies, Ms. Glenda Strauss, thank you for all that you have done, Glenda, and I am also taking this opportunity to thank you in anything that you'll be doing ahead of today. Our pastor, I'm so glad that he could be a staff member today, because I think if you have a staff member that is a pastor, you do things passionately, you know, you support and you also pray for the students so that they can achieve whatever they need to achieve. So, Mr. Pastor Martin, thank you very much. Thank you all for allowing me this time. Thank you for the enjoyable ceremony that we had. I want to also thank our invited guests that took time from all the corporates to sit here today in front of us. It's really, really appreciated. Thank you, Katrina Basson, for making sure that this event is always a success. And thank you for everyone that came to support. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Thank you very much, Ipa, for that address, that vote of thanks, and thank you to everyone once again. Just before we conclude the proceedings, I'd like to invite the graduates to please go to the back of the hall where you will receive a gift and something to drink. So the graduates, please move to the back of the hall, and then I'd like to ask our invited guests to please go with Katrina, who is at the moment in a photo shoot next to you, to please go with her to the back where we will then meet with you. Thank you so much, everybody, for being here today. Congratulations once again to our graduates. We are super proud of you guys, and I hope that you will achieve all your dreams and make all your dreams come true with this qualification. Thank you so much. I'd like to ask everybody to rise for the AU and national anthems and then wait for the academic procession to leave first.
Dedicate ourselves to us together, and our unity and unity. O sons and daughters of Africa, flesh of the sun and flesh of the sun, let us make
Hallelujah.